I am especially excited to show you this tiny house where we're at today in Marysville, Tennessee. It comes in at 254 square feet, but I'm really excited because I feel like I've been a part of their process for a while now, part of the journey, because last year they messaged me that they were building it and now it is finished and I'm finally here to check it out. It is brand new to Airbnb, the Little River Tiny House. So let's go check it out. Welcome to Tennessee and the Little River Tiny House. Brand new Airbnb that I'm super excited that I'm finally here after watching it being built over the past year. It is awesome. So this place is brand new on Airbnb. Go check out the link in the description if you want to book it or save it. If you want to host your own tiny house, there's a link down for that as well. Also, don't know if you noticed, but I'm wearing my new Homies merch. You guys can check this out and buy some as well if you want. The link is down in the description. Homies, this is the logo right here. Go check out Homies, a bunch of different types of shirts that mean a lot and you'd be helping support this channel. Anyway, along with the tour of the Airbnb, you pull up to it, you walk down this beautiful rock path that leads right to the back of your tiny house cabin. Whenever you're walking down, you'll notice the first thing on the left over here is your fire pit area. It has a couple chairs right here. It is also all stone as well. It matches the path. The views from this fire pit area are killer though. You can see the river that this tiny house is located on and beyond. So there's lots of trees, lots of gorgeous scenery to sit up here and enjoy with your friends. You can roast some s'mores. One cool thing I like about this is the rock that is in the fire pit that kind of blocks the fire and keeps it on one side, I guess. It looks really good. So now let's walk. You continue down the path to the back of your tiny house. Tyler and Amber built this tiny house all themselves, and I think they did a wonderful job. Starting with the deck that wraps around to the front, this is probably one of my favorite parts of really any tiny home. I love when tiny homes have decks, especially when it's all wood and cozy. Just really inviting, and there's lots of things to do on the deck. Like whenever we reach the front of the deck, you can see how large this is right here. There's seating options right here behind me. There's lights all around and just literally everything is wood, feels naturey, feels like you're in a cozy bubble with this tiny house cabin. One unique thing is that they have curtains up here as well. So I guess you can probably block the sun if it is ever too blinding. Sometimes that happens. Or if you want just a little bit more privacy, you can block them. Probably block out some of the bugs as well. But if you have them open, the view behind me is a perfect view for any cabin. And then you walk into your tiny house right here. So you walk into your tiny house and you'll notice how grand it is for a tiny house with the huge ceilings. This place feels massive. Right behind me, you can see how gorgeous it is. The attention to detail with everything in here, the wood aspect along with the white, the gorgeous wood floors. This place definitely screams cozy, especially with the fire pit right behind you. It's an electric fire pit and you got a TV right above it. The mantle is a piece of wood. You'll notice that around the entire house, all the shelves and everything is all wood and it looks awesome if you like the cozy vibe of a tiny house. And then over on the right of that, you have a couch. It also converts into a bed if you do want to sleep four people in this tiny house. You got windows everywhere. You can lower the blinds in all of the windows. One cool aspect is that they have these vintage postcards hung up in these frames right next to the couch. Fun to look at, and it's a unique aspect of the home. They have this huge cowhide rug in the middle of the floor. And then we make it to our kitchen area. This is a pretty large kitchen for a tiny house. You have, it's an L-shaped type of bar. The countertop is wood, of course. It matches with everything else. The cabinets are really unique though. If you look down here, they're kind of like the rounded corners, I would say. And it looks kind of vintagey. And a huge sink. You got the window right here in front of the sink to look at the views of the river. You have a mini fridge right here. You have your coffee bar right above that. And then you got some floating shelves with dishes and coffee. They provide coffee for you, which is awesome. So you got everything you need right here. The best thing about this kitchen though that I think is pretty neat is how they have this cabinet that's kind of in the wall over here. So it's sunken back, it saves space, of course, and this is where they keep their microwave and other dishes, but it looks really neat being kind of sunken back in the wall like that. I like that a lot. And then as we continue along, we got the steps that lead to the loft. We'll get to that in a bit. But if you follow me, right under here, you got some storage area for your bags, luggage. I see they have some bedding for the couch right under here. But this also connects into the closet behind me. But this is also your bathroom. So when you slide open this barn door, which is this really neat barn door. They have these different layered textured pieces of wood on it. It looks awesome. But you slide open this barn door and you walk into the bathroom. I really love this bathroom. It is spacious. You have your sink with the black fixtures that I love over here on the left. You have your toilet in the middle, a couple floating shelves above it with some bathroom amenities, and then you have your huge walk-in shower. You open up this glass door, and the really cool aspect of this is they used wood tiling for the bathroom surround. It is tile, but it looks like wood, and I've seen this before, but I've never seen it in person, and I think it looks really cool, and the black fixtures fit along with the shower as well. Now, on the other side of this bathroom is your closet area. You can hang up your clothes, which is really convenient because you'll be getting changed in the bathroom, of course, so having all your clothes here is really nice. And there's some hangers. This is also where a couple of games are and extra towels and such, but this is also where the door outside under the stairs for storage connects. So if you have storage, you can also access it in the bathroom. So this is your bathroom. It is really neat, and it's under the loft, which is where we'll be heading to next, right along these steps. So let's walk up the steps. One cool thing about these steps are the shape of them. I'll throw in a couple shots here. You can see the design of the steps are all zigzag, so they look really cool aesthetically, and they actually fit in with each step, so it's not like you're crossing your legs or anything. So if you think you're gonna trip and fall, I didn't have any issues with it. One of the really cool aspects of this home. Now let's check out the loft. Up in the loft, you have your sleeping area. This is your bed. You can overlook the ledge into the living room and kitchen area, and you have great views from up here. Since this is such a tall ceiling design tiny house, which I like a lot, the ceiling actually looks really beautiful. The architecture and the design are really eye-catching. Even the beams that go across the ceiling that hold the ceiling fan over the living room look really good. But only thing you can really fit up here is a bed, but this is the most unique part of this tiny house that I've never seen before. If we come over here, the coolest thing is that this window isn't just a window. You can open it up and it becomes a door, and you can walk out into your rooftop deck, which is incredible to have in a tiny home or really any home. So you just open it up like this and you can just take a step out. This is such a cute rooftop deck. Here's the window you walk out of. And then right over here on the other side is you have this bar area. There's four chairs for you and your friends. You can sit up here, chill, have some coffee, eat some dinner, and you can have the amazing views of the river, the trees, and the bridge over there as well. It's awesome, I love it. Over here on this side, they have some vines hanging down from your wall over here that kind of keeps you private and everything. And this is just a really intimate decking area. Your rooftop deck. They're utilizing every square inch of this tiny house and adding as much as they can. So with the decks, it is 334 square feet. Inside, I believe it's just 254 square feet. So it probably looked a lot larger than that because the ceilings and everything, but it's a really small tiny house that I enjoyed a lot. The Little River Tiny Home is one of my favorite tiny houses I've ever been to. The design and the attention to the layout of the home is really key here, and including the unique design aspects like the rooftop deck with the window that turns into a door, and to the steps that are zigzagged that look really cool, and even the storage area right under the steps. Every inch is being utilized in this tiny home, and the location is just great. I hope touring this tiny house was an inspiration to you or anybody out there that wants to build their own tiny house or dreams of living smaller but just doesn't know how. Amber and Tyler, they have day jobs, so building tiny homes isn't their trade, but they decided this is what they wanted to do. They built it and it turned out amazing. You can follow them down below and check out this place. I hope it was an inspiration. If you want to check this out, the link's down below. Also, the link for the merch is down below. And guys, I will see you in next week's video.